Hello, this is Dr. Vijay. Welcome to video series on liver function tests. This is the fifth video with respect to liver function tests. Today I am going to explain about enzymes. Most routinely sought investigations with respect to enzymes are ALT, AST, ALP and GGT. Coming to liver specific enzymes, here I have put asterisks above the specific because most of these enzymes not only express in liver, they are also expressed in other tissues or organs. These enzymes are isoenzymes, so in order to diagnose hepatobiliary disorders, we should have a sound history and clinical examinations, and also we need to correlate with other liver function tests, which I have explained in the previous four videos. Most important enzymes are alanine transaminase, aspartate transaminase or AST, alkaline phosphatase or ALP, 5' nucleotidase and gamma glutamyl transferase or GGT. So among these, ALT and AST are called aminotransferase or transaminases, and these two enzymes usually express by the hepatocytes or hepatic parenchymal cells besides various other tissues or organs. They are present in the serum in a small quantity. Whenever there is gross elevation of these two enzymes, that indicates injury to the hepatic parenchymal cells or hepatocellular diseases. As far as ALP and 5' nucleotidase is concerned, these two enzymes express by biliary canalicular membrane cells or sinusoidal membrane, and gamma glutamyl transferase usually expressed by microsomes or endoplasmic reticulum of the hepatobiliary tract cells. Their elevation indicates cholestasis or obstruction. This obstruction could be intrahepatic, as in case of intracellular jaundice, or may be extrahepatic, that is obstructive or posthepatic jaundice. So with this knowledge, the liver specific enzymes can be divided into two categories. That is, those enzymes which indicates hepatocyte damage, that is ALT and AST. And the second category is enzymes which reflect cholestasis or obstruction. It could be intrahepatic or extrahepatic, that is ALP, 5' nucleotidase and GGT. So we will go one by one. Coming to aminotransferases or transaminases, there are two, AST and ALT. Although these two enzymes are expressed in many different organs or tissues, ALT is more specific for hepatobiliary disorder compared to AST. But together, their ratio or their extent of elevation helps in diagnose many hepatobiliary disorders. The normal reference range for ALT somewhere between 10 to 45 international units per liter, and that of AST is about 10 to 40 international units per liter. Both these enzymes are elevated in hepatobiliary disorders in varying proportions. In case of viral hepatitis and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, the elevation of AST is less compared to ALT. Or in other words, elevated or concentration of ALT is more than AST. So, we can express in terms of AST-ALT ratio, it should be less than 1. This holds good for viral hepatitis and NASH, that is non-alcoholic steatohepatitis. In some disorders, the elevation of AST is more than ALT, like alcohol liver disease or alcoholic liver disease, drug-induced liver damage, and cirrhosis of the liver. So in these conditions, the elevation of AST is more than ALT. And the ratio of AST to ALT always more than 2. In these cases, for example, viral hepatitis and non-alcoholic steatohepatitis, when they advance and leading to cirrhosis, then this ratio will increase more than 1. So initially, the ratio of AST and ALT in case of viral hepatitis and NASH is less than 1. But in advanced cases of these two disorders or leading to cirrhosis, the ratio becomes more than 1. And when they reach cirrhosis, the ratio should be more than 2. So this is the point you need to remember. Coming to alkaline phosphatase, again, this enzyme expresses in many different tissues or organs. So we have to correlate with other liver function tests, as well as a proper history and a good clinical examination. The elevation of serum alkaline phosphatase always indicates cholestasis. So this could be intrahepatic or extrahepatic obstruction. The normal level somewhere between 50 to 140 international units per liter. And this elevation more than 3 times from the normal value seen in extrahepatic obstruction. That means the elevation of alkaline phosphatase more in post-hepatic or extrahepatic obstruction when compared to intrahepatic obstruction. The gross elevation of alkaline phosphatase, that is more than 1000 units per liter, seen in usually cancer or malignancies. This cancer could be primary or secondary. As I mentioned in the beginning, alkaline phosphatase is one enzyme. It has got many isoenzymes. So it is expressed in various other tissues and organs. So increased level is also seen in some other disorders like bone disorders. So we can differentiate the elevation of alkaline phosphatase by separation of these isoenzymes by electrophoresis, or we can, along with the alkaline phosphatase, if we measure 5' nucleotidase and GGT, because these two are also markers for cholestasis, and their elevation always parallel with elevation of alkaline phosphatase. So in this way, we can differentiate alkaline phosphatase elevation in terms of hepatobiliary disorders and other disorders, mainly bone disorders. Gamma-glutamyl transferase, also known as GGT, it is a microsomal enzyme expressed in endoplasmic reticulum of the hepatobiliary tract cells or membrane cells. Gamma-glutamyl transferase enzyme synthesis can be induced by alcohol or various drugs like phenytoin, usually used to treat epilepsy, warfarin, anticoagulant, rifampicin, anti-TB drug. So these drugs and alcohol can induce synthesis of GGT. So that means whenever a chronic alcoholic patient or alcohol abuse, so we can expect increased GGT serum levels. Similarly, those patients who are taking phenytoin for treatment of epilepsy or warfarin for thrombolytic therapy and rifampicin for tuberculosis. The normal level of GGT is about 30 units per liter. That is, upper limit is about 30 units per liter. And their elevation seen alcoholic hepatitis. So they say this is the marker for alcoholic hepatitis. The elevation of GGT is the marker for alcoholic liver disease. Moderate elevation of GGT also seen in infectious hepatitis. And the elevation of GGT is parallel to elevation of alkaline phosphatase as seen in cholestasis. That is, it could be intrahepatic or extrahepatic obstruction. And gross elevation of GGT seen in malignancies of liver may be primary neoplasms of the liver or may be secondary or metastasis. Mild elevation of GGT also seen in case of fatty liver. The last enzyme is 5' nucleotidase, is also known as nucleotide phosphatase or NTP. Reference range for 5' nucleotidase is about 2 to 10 international units per liter. Increased serum level of 5' nucleotidase seen in hepatobiliary diseases, most commonly seen in cholestasis or obstruction. That obstruction could be intrahepatic or extrahepatic cholestasis. Most of the time, the elevation of 5' nucleotidase always parallel with elevation of alkaline phosphatase. Most routinely sought investigations in case of enzymes in liver function tests are ALT, AST, ALP, GGT. So in order to differentiate, we can do 5' nucleotidase, but these enzymes along with other liver function tests helps in differential diagnosis of hepatobiliary disorders. The essential point you need to remember, these enzymes are not only expressed in liver, they are also expressed in various other tissues or organs. So we need to keep in mind the history, the clinical examination, and correlate with all liver function test which we discuss in previous videos. And also most of the time we need to confirm either by ultrasonography or MRI or CT scan. Thanks for watching.